This is Earthheart, and here is Michael.
It's hard to understand how people can elect leadership like the leadership we have here in the United States. How people can elect the current carnival barking mendacious tub of hubris seems beyond our ability to understand. But believe it or not, it was practically this bad 12 years ago. That's when I wrote this fictional piece in my blog, Earth Family Alpha. I rolled over and tried to go back into the dream, but something, a flash, had taken me out of dreamland. What was that? What? That flash of light. It was like a lightning bolt, but I didn't hear any thunder. Janelle opened her eyes slowly and then closed them again. What time is it? She said in that voice I always love. I don't know. I looked at the clock. It was flashing. Apparently, the electricity had gone off for just a moment. That probably explained the flash. A transformer must have blown up, but then if it had blown up, the electricity would not have come back on. It's 5 o'clock. Go back to sleep. Janelle went to sleep again. I tried to go back to sleep too, but there was too much energy in the air. I laid in the bed. I could feel something. There was a little tingle in my spine, in my head. It was some sensation. There were these lights. I watched them as they played in my mind's eye. They would come together and then dance apart. Then they would come in from the corners and come to the center, and then they would move around each other like two planets locked in each other's orbits. And as these little stars of light continued to play on the stage in my mind's eye, I began to hear a humming. It was barely audible, but I could feel it deep in the back of my spine and somewhere in the back of my brain. It rose up from there and kind of found a place in the center. It was not really a sound, it was more like a vibration. It was pleasant, but I'm not sure why. I went in and out of sleep most of the morning dreaming, but most of the time I was watching those lights. It was like watching an opera without the people. The morning came and it was beautiful. No, it was remarkable. I don't recall ever seeing a sunset so splendid. The colors, oranges, turquoise. Venus was in the morning sky. I could see it until just before the sun hit the horizon. Janelle got up and walked down the hallway. She has always been beautiful, but somehow today she looked like she had lost 10 years of age. If sex appeal was quantifiable, hers was off the chart. She hadn't even rubbed her eyes and got the sleep out of them yet. I looked out the window and the tops of the houses and into the hills. Our little part of the world looked pretty good, and the moisture rising from the trees gave a medium to the sunlight's splendor. It was All Saints' Day. My computer was bringing in the day's news. You know, I can select any kind of interface I want to hear or see, so I decided to select Walter Cronkite. For some reason, I had chosen him to read the news to me while I started the water for the shower. Authorities report that a flash of light was seen this morning at about 5 a.m. The flash was seen all over the world, even in China, where it is now 5 p.m. There was a discernible brief increase of light. Clocks all over the globe momentarily suffered a disruption in power supply, and the report went on. Authorities at the Naval Observatory are now reporting that the atomic clock that is used to accurately mark time has experienced an unprecedented loss of an instant. As the day progressed, a host of remarkable things began to occur. Brett Hume at Fox News abruptly veered from his prepared talking points and suddenly began speaking about the need to bring all the troops home. He looked deep into the camera and seemed for the first time, at least to me, to be almost human. Old Greybeard at CNN was interviewing Scotty, and he suddenly decided to ask him how he could possibly say that the president wanted to get to the bottom of the spy case when all he really had to do was ask the perpetrators on his staff to turn in their resignations. Scotty didn't have an answer. Then Scotty said, "You're right. It's just not plausible, is it? I feel like an idiot reciting this stuff." By noon, the Congress had convened an emergency session. The purpose? Every member had simultaneously decided that climate change must be addressed now. Most were talking about bringing the troops home and using that money to develop new, highly advanced forms of energy that would make oil and gas and coal, as well as nuclear, totally passé. By the late afternoon, the Supreme Court announced that Roe v. Wade was now sacrosanct, and they declared the Patriot Act unconstitutional. By that evening, the president made a speech that would become the basis of the recovery of the world from these most dark times. Everything changed in a twinkling. Astronomers at the National Observatory said that a flash came from the center of the galaxy, and they had no idea how it was generated. They just knew it was effective. It was a smart bomb. This is Earthheart, news you can use, the pulse of the planet.
Earthheart is produced by Michael Osborne in cooperation with James College.